with a tune written by Bobby Troup. Any of you are old enough here, are you, there are people who are old enough to remember the television show Emergency? Now, Bobby Troup was one of the doctors on Emergency, and his wife, Julie London, the beautiful singer, was one of the nurses on the show. Now, she was definitely on the show because of her looks, not because of the fact that she looked like a nurse, but she looked like a supermodel. So, and she sang pretty well, too. But this is a tune written by Bobby Troup that was actually, the biggest hit was done by a fellow from Alabama by the name of Nathaniel Coles, also known as Nat King Cole. It's called Get Your Kicks on Route 66. Thank you. on Route 66. Get your kicks. Get your kicks. Get your kicks. I said get your kicks. Get your kicks. Route 66. So very much.
Yeah.
Gotta get my technology straight here. Here's a tune, number 20. That's the wrong set. Excuse. We're gonna, This is 102.
Yeah,
for those of you who are following.
We really like that one.
Following, yeah, I thought everybody in particular. That's for the people who are following along in your hymnals. We have some extra parts here, too. This is a tune written by one of America's greatest composers, a fellow by the name of Israel Isidore Berlin. Everybody's heard of Israel Berlin. Also known as Irving Berlin.
Irving.
Such a nice boy. But this is a beautiful tune that was originally introduced in a Broadway show by Ethel Merman. Right. Everybody knew Ethel. I called her Ethel. I don't need no stinking microphone. But it's also a beautiful ballad, the way it was recorded by Johnny Hartman, the great vocalist, along with John Coltrane on an album of ballads that they did. And it's a tune called "They Say It's Wonderful." They say that falling in love is wonderful. So wonderful. So they say. This thing that's known as romance is wonderful. So wonderful. So they tell me. I can't recall who said it. I know I never read it. I only know they tell me that love is grand. And if there's a moon up above, it's wonderful, wonderful. never read it. I only know they tell me that love is grand. And if there's a moon up above, thing about Irving is that he could not read a note of music. He could neither read nor write music, and whenever he thought of a song, and he could only play in one key, F sharp, mostly black notes, you know? He and Stevie, yeah. And but yet he became one of our most beloved popular songwriters. He had it here. Here. Great heart in the song. Don't you agree with me? What a beautiful ballad that is. They say it's wonderful. Expressed beautiful sentiments. Now there's two guys from the Midwest. There have been a lot of wonderful Midwestern musicians, but two in particular that were great songwriters. And one was Cole Porter. The other one was Hoagie Carmichael. Hoagie, short for Hoagland. Yes. He was named after the Hoagland Traveling Circus. It's true. But they both went to Indiana University. They grew up within 10 miles of each other, but never knew each other until they moved to New York and were successful songwriters, Hoagie Carmichael and Cole Porter. They even both went to Indiana University. Different times. One was, I think, Cole was a little bit older, 5 or 6 years older than Hoagie, and they actually both joined the same fraternity, Sigma Chi. Hoagie Carmichael wrote the arrangement of The Sweetheart of Sigma Chi that's used to this very day. So, isn't that interesting? I mean, there's two brilliant songwriters like that. Whose paths never crossed until they were successful songwriters and they lived in New York City. But this is a tune by Cole Porter now called I've Got You Under My Skin. Thank you. my skin. Mexican restaurant or a Chinese restaurant. Oh, I want number 104. Yeah. Well, you know, this reminds me of a joke. Guys in a prison, you know.
Oh, he knows.
And they have a joke period, you know, every day when somebody stands up and tells a joke. And finally, they had told all the jokes that they knew, and they had them all memorized, and they cataloged them by number, so that all they had to do was one guy will stand up and go, 23, and everybody will laugh uproariously. That's 72. Yeah, they're all laughing uproariously. And the new guy in the prison there thinks, well, I'll give it a shot. And he stands up and goes, 44. Nobody laughs. Well, try another one. 45. Nobody laughs. So he sits down, he's all dejected about it. He said, I didn't get a laugh. And his buddy says, well, some people know how to tell a joke and others don't. I don't get no respect. The other night I went into a topless joint and the place didn't have a roof on it. Thank you, buddy. Okay, here's a great tune by Alan Lerner and Fred Lowe. Another one of our terrific all-American great songwriting teams. They wrote over 700 songs in their career. And there's a joke among Broadway people that Alan and Fred must have written two or three before breakfast every morning. But this is a great tune from Brigadoon called Almost Like Being in Love. Thank you. aerobic music there. You know. For the musicians as well. I want to tell you, I'm going to brag a little bit more about the background of these fabulous musicians that are on stage with me. John Knuckles over there studied jazz drumming with a fellow named Alan Dawson, who used to play with Dave Rubeck.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And, he got... Alan had his own method for teaching jazz drumming, and it worked, didn't it? Yes. So he's not just a drummer. The old joke goes, so what do you call a guy that hangs around with a bunch of musicians? A drummer. But John is a true drummer's drummer. He's a musician, and he plays colors and beautiful phrasing. And I can't say enough about this guy right here, because this is, in my 45 plus year career as a professional musician, I've never encountered a better reader than this guy. Unbelievable. Chris Wendell on the bass. And the astounding thing is that he's a bass player, but he also can read treble clef. Not, honestly, there's a lot of symphonic bass players that struggle with reading treble clef. But not Chris. Chris, you can stick anything in front of him and practically he'll read it. Now, two great songwriters, great songwriting team. There's a guy named Richard Rogers who wrote with Oscar Hammerstein, and he also wrote with Lawrence Hart, lyricist Lawrence Hart. This particular one is written by Lawrence Hart. It's from one of their Broadway shows and a movie called Pal Joey. Remember that? This is just a beautiful, it's a soliloquy, really. The original, this is Bewitched, Bothered, and Bewildered. And it's in the show, it's actually a musical soliloquy in the tradition of all the great soliloquies from Shakespeare and all the great playwrights. And it has many more verses than I'm going to do tonight, but it's such a beautiful tune on top of it. A heartfelt melody, beautiful. Everything about this song is a near perfect song, if not perfect. Bewitched, Bothered, and Bewildered. She's a fool, and don't I know it? But a fool can have her charms. I'm in love and don't I show it, like a babe in arms. Love's the same old sad sensation. Lately I've not slept a wink. Since this half-pint imitation put me on the blink, I'm wild again, beguiled again, simpering, whimpering child. Laugh, but I love it, although the laugh's on God, I love it. Favorites, and it's from the musical You'll Never Know. We don't remember the musical, but boy, the song is dynamite. It's called At Long Last Love. Shock. Is this the good turtle soup or really the mock? Is it a cocktail, this feeling of joy? Or is what I feel the real McCoy? Is it for all time or simply a lark? Is this Granada I see or only Asbury Park? Is this a fancy not worth thinking? Sponsor. Actually, I have been working for a little over a year now on a new album project, a CD project, and I hope to do some of it in this very room. Some of it have it be a live recording with an audience, because that's the way jazz should be. You know, it's you can go into the studio and record jazz, and you can get some nice recordings from it. But it's never quite as good as when you do it in front of an audience, and you get that vibe going, you know, and that interaction between the audience and the musicians. So I'm going to invite all of y'all to pay attention to my website and my Facebook page. Facebook page, Ray Reach. I actually have two Facebook pages, Ray Reach and Ray Reach Roman numeral 2. I outgrew Ray Reach, and I had 5,000 friends there, so now I have 4,700 friends on Ray Reach Roman numeral 2. A lot of these people, I have no clue who they are. But, yeah, that's the way it is. But I also have a website, which is easy enough, rayreach.com. And you can find out what's going on in my career and in my life there. I try to keep it updated with the performances and information about upcoming performances. So please pay attention, and I'll invite you all back. You've been so lovely tonight to participate in our live recording here. I hope to do 3 or 4 days in a row here. And I hope that's okay, Michelle. I haven't talked to her about it. Well, she'll get paid, you know. we'll have some great musicians here in the room, among them these two wonderful guys here. Let's have another round of applause for this fabulous rhythm section. I don't know. Anyhow, all the Facebook postings is ridiculous. I have 11 Facebook pages that I try to keep up with. Well, it's a great way to communicate, and I've connected with many friends, old friends that I haven't heard from in 20 or 30 years, you know, on Facebook. It's a great thing. And some of them remind me of the money that I owe them. Or one guy threatened to come over and burn my house down, you know. We're going to do a tune now that was written by the other Hoosier. We've done a couple by that famous Hoosier, Cole Porter. Now we're going to do one by Hoagland Carmichael. And this is one of the greatest, most beloved popular songs. You know what it is. It's called Georgia on My Mind.
Joe.
Georgia. Oh, Georgia. No peace I find. Just an old sweet song. Guys, it's kind of like playing with these guys is kind of like laying down on a fine feather bed.
Oh, really? Tell us more.
I beg your pardon.
More.
they give you the support that you need to be able to play freely.
I'm talking.
Sally.
You're bad.
You better be quiet.
You gotta watch what you say around Sally, because she takes it immediately to the gutter.
I learned it all from him, right?
Well,
we're
about
closing soon before it goes into any further. All right, we opened with a blues, our set with a blues, and we're going to close with a blues. Now, this is one that I kind of kludged together from three different songs. One song by Mose Allison, who just died in this past year. Great Mose Allison. And called Your Mind Is On Vacation and Your Mouth Is Working Overtime. Another one that was originally done by Woody Herman and then remade by Ray Charles called I Got News For You.
Yeah.
And another verse by the late great B.B. King, who we just lost in the last week. You're sitting here yakking, right in my face. I guess I'm gonna have to put you right in your place. You know, if silence was golden, Sally, you couldn't raise a dime. You're quoting figures and dropping names. You're telling stories about the names. I just kissed a girl. Oh, look at you. You're overlapping when things ain't funny. You're trying to sound like money. You know if talk was criminal, you lead a life of crime. Because your mind's on vacation and your mouth is working overtime. The whole it's for you. Said love from Daddy-O. Honey. I got news for you. Somehow your story just don't ring true. I got news for you. True story now, so listen close. It's really happening. A brand new Ford. She said, huh, I want a Cadillac. I took her all out for $100 dinner. She said, yeah, thanks for the snack. Yeah. I took her all up to my penthouse. She said, it's cute, but it's just a shack. I gave her seven children. Now she wants to give them back. Talk is cheap. Yeah. Don't be making promises that you can't keep. If you don't like this little song I'm singing, just grin and bear it. All I can say is if the shoe fits, wear it. And if you must keep talking, please just try to make it rhyme.
That's all we know, we all go home.
No, that's not true.